having one running back and a couple of fullbacks. Now I lost count. I don't know how many running backs you have now. You got a pretty deep group, though, right?
Yes, we do. Now I'm excited. Excited about each one of them. Each one of them have talented. They bring something to the table. And it's great to have numbers. And now it's just up to me, it's the coach, to get those guys going in the right way, right direction, knowing who they have, pass protection, teaching them the scheme.
At a certain point in camp, you'll have to pare down the reps. But I mean, at this point, how do you make sure everybody gets a lot of work, gets enough work?
Well, our Coach Chris does a good job of having a young guys, Skelly, you know, and that type of thing, and kind of separating the older guys from the freshmen. And so we're able to get those guys high number of reps during that period. But throughout practice, they know that they're going to get one or two reps each period. And it kind of helps keep them involved, keeps them alert, make sure that they're watching the rep, the next rep the, in front of them, and keeps them in tune with what's happening.
What excites you the most about Connor and Bennett, the presumed front runners in that group?
Well, the fact that they're battle tested. For one thing, they both bring a lot of experience to the table. You know, James, you know, not as much, but I think he has a great upside with his size, speed combination. He has an opportunity to do some great things here. And Isaac, his ability to play on all three downs, you got to like that as a coach. He's a smart player. A guy that's not going to get you beat. And you know, right now we're bringing him along slowly because of the surgery, but I'm excited about both of those guys.
Have you done sharing James with Coach Palermo a little bit early on in this training camp?
Oh yes, I don't think I can get around that, unfortunately. And to his credit, he's doing a heck of a job of keeping up with both installs, offensively and defensively, and he's enjoying it. And I think as a coach, you want guys that want to play, that enjoy football, love football. And right now he's a guy that's loving the game because he's able to do something that a lot of guys can't do, that's play on both sides.
Have you ever dealt with a situation like this before, a guy playing both ways?
No, and it's a little different. Uh-huh. But he's talented enough to do it. I think the success that he had in the bowl game, I think he's proven that he can do some things on third down with his speed, power combination as a pass rusher. I think as a coach, you'd be crazy not to take advantage of it.
You've never seen it in any teams you ever played on where running back went to the other side?
No, sir. This is the first.
What have you seen of Chris James? I know it's only 2 days in. Your thoughts?
It's 2 days. I'm excited about Chris James. Young guy that is living up to everything that you saw on film when they recruited him. When I got in, first thing I did was to look at all of the guys that they had signed. I knew that he was a guy that had a lot of talent in high school, did a lot of things. But as you guys know, when you get to this level, it's a totally different deal. And every rep has been a good rep because he's learned something from it. And you know, today he found out that he couldn't run away from a lot of these guys. And that he needs to play within the scheme and do the things that we coach him to do. And his speed will serve him better if he can do things the way we ask him.
You're asking him to do a few different things. He's coming out of the backfield, a bunch of passes, walking, running.
Well, he's a talented young man, and he's proven that he can catch the ball. We know everybody knows he can run it. He has a good hand, and so we're going to take advantage of those things. And in today's game, I think you got to be a complete player. You got to be a great athlete. You got to be able to block. You got to be able to run. You got to be able to catch it. And the biggest thing, I like the problem so far, he hasn't shown any fear when it comes to pass protection. Stepped up in blitz periods and took guys on, and he's not with the young guys. He's going against the best. So that was a good thing to see. That's promising.
When the pads get on later this week, will you scale back what Isaac's doing?
Yes. We'll like I said, we'll take a slow approach. He'll get a lot of things in Indy, and when we go offense, teaching drills and that type of thing. He'll get a few things maybe in Skelly, but when we go team, we'll try to hold him out for the first few days and let him kind of work his way back up.
You talk about the 30-plus running backs you have on this team. When you're working with guys with different skill sets and different sizes, how do you balance out? Is it as tough as it seems to balance out how much they're working and also like just their different skill sets, kind of capitalizing on those and working on them?
Well, I think you have to have a plan. And right now our plan is to play certain guys on first and second down, let those guys get a couple of the reps, and then have a group of guys that work sub, a third down package. And I think if, with that approach, like I said, guys not going to get a ton of reps, but the guys that need to get reps, that need to get on film, need to be evaluated, they'll have an opportunity to get on film and you can move forward from there. But right now, and, you guys said it, early on it's tough with the numbers, but we find a way to get everybody involved.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, buddy. Thank you.